Hello friends, welcome to Autonomous Academy. Myself Pratita Amrakar, I am a MSc student. So today in this video we will discuss about a very interesting topic, that is X-ray. So let's first know about what are the X-rays. The X-rays are the electromagnetic waves or the part of electromagnetic spectrum, therefore transverse wave of high photon energy, short wavelength and high frequency, travel at the speed of light. They cannot be reflected, refracted, and therefore cannot be focused. X-rays are ionizing radiation that can pass through the matter. The wavelength of X-rays lies in the electromagnetic spectrum at the range of 10 to the power minus 10, and in angstrom, its range is 0.01 to 100 angstrom. We will discuss this topic under following headings: introduction, production, applications, spectrum, and properties of X-rays. Let's start with introduction. On 8 November 1895, German professor William Conrad Röntgen accidentally found during his experiment that if the crystal of barium platinum cyanide are placed near a cathode ray tube, they glow brightly, but the source of CR tube was covered with a cardboard box. So he concluded that some invisible radiations were coming out from the tube, which were able to penetrate through the cardboard box, while the cathode rays cannot pass through the cardboard box. So he further noticed that these radiations are able to penetrate through any object and they travel in a straight line and does not get deflected in an electromagnetic field. On 22 December 1895, he took the first ever human X-rays, which was the palm of his wife Bartha, and on 28 December 1895, he presented his discovery to the world, and for this invention, he was awarded by the Nobel Prize in 1901. After the discovery of X-rays, initially X-rays studio were open only for the entertainment purpose, but further with the time, they found it's important in medical science and also in the other science stream. But during these days, adverse effect of X-rays were not known, because of which many skin problems, hair fall, body pain, skin cancer, etc. occurs. And after the death of Clarence Daly, who was the helper of Thomas Alva Edison, due to the skin cancer, which is acute because of the extensive exposure of X-rays, a research is started to find the methods of secure uses and safety measures of X-rays. As we know, by the help of Bohr model, the electrons revolve around the nucleus in the circular orbit, and if the highly energetic electron collides with the electron which is revolving in the orbit, the electron may knock out and a vacancy is created in that place. So the nearby electrons approaches to fill this vacancy, and in this process they release their extra energy in the form of electromagnetic radiation. And this radiation is known as the X-rays. Actually, the photoelectric effect and the X-ray production are inverse process to each other. Let's have a look on photoionic emission and thermoionic emission, which is helpful to understand the production of X-ray. In photonic emission, a high frequency light is made incident on a metal. So the electron of the metal get energy from the photons of light, and the energy of electrons increases more than to their work function, and as a result the electron leaves the metal surface. In this emission, the energy of electron suddenly get increased, and the kinetic energy of electron is equal to the h nu minus phi, where h nu is the energy of photon and phi is the work function. In thermionic emission, which occurs due to the heat, the kinetic energy of electron increases slowly, and as the energy of electron reaches to their work function, they leaves the metal surface. So the kinetic energy of these electrons is zero. The basic difference between the photonic emission and thermionic emission, that in photonic emission the electrons have sufficient energy, while in thermionic emission the ejected electrons have no energy. Now we will consider the production of X-rays with the help of Cooley's tube, which is based on thermionic emission. In Cooley's tube, there is a filament F and a potential Vf is applied across the filament F, and due to this, electric field is produced and also a current is flow in the filament F. So the filament F is get heated due to this flowing current, and the voltage Vf is set to the value so that it can emits the electron continuously. And as we know that the in thermoanichemation, the emitted electrons have zero kinetic energy, therefore to accelerate them, an accelerating potential V0 is applied. The accelerated electron strike on the target with a great velocity, and the target is made of heavy metals of high atomic number and high melting point like tungsten and molybdenum. The envelope is shown here is made up of metal because metal is opaque to X-rays, and for obtaining a X-ray beam in a certain region we use Mylar window from which we can get X-rays beam. Because Mylar window is transparent to X-rays, due to the continuous collision of electron, the temperature of target is increases. So to control this temperature, a cold water and cold oil tube is used. When electron ejected from filament F, its kinetic energy initially zero, but due to the presence of accelerating voltage V0, its kinetic energy become maximum, that is EV0, before the striking to the target. So the energy of electron somewhat lie in between the zero and EV0 value. The energy of photon can be written as 0 less than hc upon lambda less than equals to EV0, and it can also be written as 0 less than 1 upon lambda less than equals to EV0 hc, and therefore infinity greater than lambda greater than equals to hc upon EV0. Finally, we can say the wavelength of X-ray photon lie between the hc upon EV0 and infinity. So a minimum wavelength lambda minimum equals to hc upon EV0 frequency light are produced only when the total kinetic energy of electron is used to emit the photon during collision, and in this state there is no loss of energy in the form of heat. In other words, a light of minimum wavelength is obtained from a photon of high energy or frequency. With the help of graph, it is clear that we cannot obtain photon of wavelength less than 2 lambda minimum. Now we will discuss about the types of X-rays. So on the basis of nature of spectrum, there are two types, continuous spectrum and characteristic spectrum. And on the basis of intensity and penetrating power, there are two types, hard X-rays and soft X-rays. So later we discuss in detail. Let's discuss about the difference between hard X-rays and soft X-rays. So when we increase the filament voltage Vf, the emission of electrons increases, and due to which emission of photon is also increases, and so the intensity of X-rays increases. So finally we can say the intensity of X-rays is the function of Vf. The second parameter of X-ray is penetration power, which is depend on energy. So when we increase the accelerating voltage V0, we see that the kinetic energy of electron is increases. So the penetration power of electron is increases. So we can say the penetration power P is equals to the function of V0. If the penetration power of X-rays is high, it means it is the hard X-rays. While the soft X-rays have low penetration power and low intensity. Now we will discuss about the X-ray spectra. There are two types of X-ray spectra on the basis of nature, as we know that. First is continuous X-ray spectra and second is characteristic X-ray spectra. So let's start with continuous X-ray spectra. So as we know that due to the presence of accelerating potential, the ejected electron from the filament get accelerated and collide to the atom of target with a great velocity. So on collision, the kinetic energy suddenly get decreased, and this decrease in energy has two causes. One is emission of photon and second is loss in the form of heat or phonon. The energy of emitted electron is lies between the 0 to E V0 During the collision, when the kinetic energy is completely used in photon emission, so the minimum wavelength of radiation corresponding to the maximum energy EV naught will be lambda minimum equals to hc upon EV naught. So when highly accelerated electron ejected from filament get deaccelerated from passing nearly to the nucleus of target atom, so this decrease of energy is shown in the graph as decay, as photon decay. When the accelerating electron passes in the vicinity of nucleus, they feel retardation. But on the other hand, if accelerating electron passes through the target atom far from the nucleus, it has greater velocity, and the intensity of X-ray photon will be depend on the distance between accelerating electron and the nucleus. So we get continuous spectra. Here in the graph, on taking the wavelength on X-axis and intensity on the Y-axis, we can see the curves 1, 2, 3. And here these points are the lambda minimum, that is minimum wavelength. On increasing the filament potential VF, the emission in electron will be increased, but the velocity of all electrons will be same, because of which the value of lambda minimum will not be changed. But on increasing the number of photon, we get curve 2. If accelerating potential is increased, then the electron collides with the target with the great velocity, by which the number of collision and the number of emitted electron both increases, and we get a curve 3, and lambda minimum, that is minimum wavelength, is decreased. This figure shows the atomic structure and the orbits of the target atom. Here K, L, M, N are the orbits, and if the accelerated electron knock out the electron from K shell, then the electrons from M and L tends to approach fill this vacancy created in K shell. When the electrons of higher energy levels fill the vacancy of K shell, we get the K series lines, and when the electrons of higher energy levels fill the vacancy of L shell, we get the L series, and so on. For the filling the vacancy of M shell, M series characteristic lines are obtained. As we know that higher orbital have high energy in comparison of lower orbit, and electrons of these higher orbitals release their extra energy in the form of X-ray photon to fill the vacancy of lower orbital. Wavelength of light produced by the transition from L shell to the K shell. Then, according to Bohr's model, 1 upon lambda square is equals to R into Z square 1 upon N1 square minus 1 upon N2 square, where R is the Rydberg's constant and Z is the atomic number, and N1 and N2 are the number of orbits. This formula is not correct for the atom of many electrons, because of the vacancy is affected by the other electrons present in an atom. So the modified form of above equation is 1 upon lambda equals to R into Z minus B ka whole square 1 upon N1 ka square minus 1 upon N2 ka square, where R is Rydberg's constant and B is screening constant. For the transition from L shell to the K shell, the equation can be written as 1 upon lambda equals to R Z minus B ka whole square 1 upon 1 minus 1 upon fair. On solving this equation, we can get a result root nu is equals to root 3 RC upon 4 and Z minus B. For the transition from L shell to K shell, the value of B, that is screen constant, will be 1, and thus root nu is directly proportional to Z, or root nu is directly proportional to Z square. Since the frequency of X-ray spectrum is directly proportional to the atomic number of the target matter, therefore we can say it has characteristic spectra. This is called the Moseley's law. Here the characteristic spectra is shown. On X-axis there is wavelength, and on Y-axis relative intensity. So you can see the curve, and the characteristic lines AK alpha, K beta, L alpha and L beta. The maximum energy of emitted electrons, that is E max, is equals to EV naught or EV. And H nu max, we can write the energy as HV max equals to EV, and nu max is equals to EV upon H. And we can also write this equation as C upon H minimum, that is lambda minimum, equals to EV upon H. And the lambda minimum equals to HC upon EV, that is lambda minimum is equals to 12.375 upon V angstrom. The value of lambda minimum is inversely proportional to accelerated potential. So for K alpha ray, the value of nu will be EL minus EK upon H. For K beta ray, nu will be EM minus EK upon H. And similarly, for L alpha ray, nu will be EM minus EL upon H. Till now, we have discussed about the definition of X-rays, X-ray spectrum, and also X-ray production. Now we will discuss about the properties and the application of X-rays. Now, the property of X-rays. First, they are the radiation of high energy. Second, they have ionization power. Third, it causes fluorescence. Fourth, it affects the photographic plate. Fifth, decomposition of water, that is H2O molecule. Sixth, affects the rate of mechanism of enzyme. Seven, destroy the process of fermentation. It has the power of sterilization, and it also has the power of physical disorder. Now, let's know about the application of X-ray. So there are many more applications of X-rays in the various field of life. Some of them are in medical science, as we know that X-rays are used to detect the defect of body and defect of bones. Second, in X-ray crystallography, in which the pattern of crystal lattice can be recorded and produced by the X-ray diffraction, which is called X-ray diffraction pattern. And a related technique, that is in fiber diffraction, was used by Rosalind Franklin to discover the double helical structure of DNA. Now, in X-ray astronomy, which is an observational branch of astronomy which deals with the study of X-ray emission from the celestial object. In X-ray microscopy analysis, which uses electromagnetic radiation in the soft ray band to produce image of very small object. In X-ray fluorescence, a technique in which X-ray are generated with a specimen and detected. In industrial radiography, use X-rays for inspection of the industrial part, which particularly welds. Today, we have discussed about the introduction, production and spectra of X-rays. We have also discussed their properties and application. So, we hope this video will be helpful to you. Thanks for watching. Please like and share the video and subscribe our channel. Thank you.